The third example which we are going to take is restricted distribution. Restricted distribution. Here we were talking about the discontinuous distribution, that distribution is at a random tarike se hua hai distribution, it is not in a continuous form, one by one distribution nahi hua hai. And here we will talk about the restricted distribution, ki ek hi jagah par kisi particular organism ka present hona. Suppose, for example, we will take the marsupials or the placental mammals. The marsupial mammals, not placental mammals, or egg-laying mammals. These marsupial mammals and egg-laying mammals, these are only present in Australia. These marsupial mammals are only present in the Australia. So, why they are only present in Australia, why they are not present in rest of the world? Because these Australia got separated in when there was the placental mammals were not evolved or were not developed on the mainland. Australia mainland se us time par develop hua jab mainland par bhi isi type ke organisms the, egg-laying mammals were present, and at that time when the placental mammals or the higher mammals were not evolved on the mainland, at that time the Australia got separated from the mainland. So Australia separate ho gaya, alag continent ban gaya, and it was also both the continents were also being separated by the large or the huge barriers of the oceans and the mountains. So separation hone ke baad mein, how that highly evolved placental mammals will go to the Australian continent, kis tarah se wo jo highly evolved placental mammals jo develop hue hain on the mainland, to wo kis tarah se fir Australian continent par jayenge. Therefore Australia gets devoid of that placental mammals, and it consisted only of the marsupial mammals or the egg laying mammals, or we can say that pouched mammals. So here we will take the one more example in the restricted distribution, that marsupial mouse and the normal mouse, or we can say that this restricted distribution is also the example of the convergent evolution. How? Let us discuss it now. Marsupial mouse and the normal mouse, which was present on the mainland. So when this marsupial mouse is having the another kind of activities, or its habitat is alag, its food habits are alag, its general properties or general characteristics will be different, or its general habits will be different from the from this mainland mouse. So these both of these organisms, though they are the same, they are from the same species of the mouse, or we can say that they are from the same class, though they are from the same class, they are different from each other due to the because they are present on the, or they are being developed on the different continent. Ye dono ek jaise hone ke baad mein bhi different continent per different environmental conditions hone ke karan, they developed as the two different animals. So the marsupial mouse is different from the mainland mouse. Par jab hum in marsupial mouse or jo mainland mouse hai, when they are placed at one place, or agar hum usse un dono ko ek hi place par agar rakhe, and same type of environmental conditions were provided to them, and the same kind of food habits were also provided to them, then these both will show the same characteristics, or these both will show the same functions as we see in the convergent type of evolution. Convergent evolution mein humne kya padha tha, that it was an example of the analogous organs, that function same hota hai but their origin is different. So here also, when both of these organisms were kept at a single place, jab un dono organisms ko hum ek single place par rakhenge, though they are belonging to the different categories, though they are belonging from the different continents, they are belonging from the different environmental conditions, they have the different kind of food habits, इन सब differences के बाद भी जब हम उन्हें same जगह पर रखेंगे, they will show the same kind of functions, वो एक ही जैसा function perform करेंगे. Therefore, the restricted distribution is an example of the convergent evolution also, or it shows the convergent evolution also. So, this was all about the biogeographical evidences. In this, we have first discussed about the Darwin finches. Darwin finches, these were found on the Madagascar island, and this Madagascar island is the bunch of 22 small islands. I forgot to tell you that Madagascar island is the bunch of 22 small islands, and it was discovered, Darwin finches were discovered by the Darwin. He found the 20 varieties of the bird, and they were belonging to the same species of the bird, or they were belonging to the same the grain eating bird, from the one, they developed from the one grain eating bird. So though they were from the same species, they were different in their two aspects. They were having the different size, and they were also having the different shape of the beak. Why this was different? Due to the difference in the environmental conditions, and also in the also due to the difference in their food habits. The next or the second example which we have taken was discontinuous distribution. Here we have again repeated that process of the Pangaea, that Pangaea or the huge landmass get distributed due to the geographical distribution, or distribution hone ke baad mein some of the organisms might be possible that they have been died, and some of the organisms remains alive at that continent, and this was the reason that for the discontinuous distribution ki कुछ ऑर्गेनिजम्स कुछ कॉन्टिनेंट्स पर तो प्रेजेंट है, पर कुछ ऑर्गेनिजम्स दूसरे कॉन्टिनेंट्स पर प्रेजेंट नहीं है. दिस वॉज द रीजन फॉर द डिसकंटिन्यूस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. एंड हियर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द एलिगेटर्स एंड द मैग्नोलियास और द ट्यूलिप्स. And the third example which we have taken is about restricted distribution. Restricted distribution means किसी बहुत सारे एक वेराइटी के एनिमल, the one variety of the animal is restricted only to the particular place, कि वो एक ही जगह पर restrict होकर रह गया है, दूसरी जगह पर वो जा नहीं सकता for the further evolution or for the further development. The examples which we have taken here was the marsupial mammals or the eagling mammals, which are found only in the Australia. These are restricted to the particular this continent. They cannot move to the another continent for the further evolution. Therefore, they have been restricted to the eagling only. They cannot develop or they cannot evolve to the placental mammals like the other mammals have been evolved. So, this was all about the biogeographical evidences. Now we will discuss about our fourth category in the evidences of evolution, that is embryological evidences. So the fourth category of the the fourth category under the evidences of evolution that we are going to study is embryological evidences. Embryological evidences. So, the study of the embryology, हम embryological studies क्यों करते हैं? Why we study the embryological development of various organisms? We study the embryological evidences to see the similarities in the embryos of various animals. हम different animals के embryos की similarity, और we can say that we want to study the similarities between the embryos of the different animals. Therefore, we used to study the embryology of the embryology of the different animals. The important thing father of embryology. Aristotle and father of modern embryology is von Baer. Father of embryology is Aristotle and father of modern embryology is von Baer. So, before discuss, let us take examples, or let us take a couple of examples to understand this embryological evidences. Early development in triploblast. Early development in the triploblast. Why the early development in triploblast? Because the earlier development or the embryological development in triploblast is quite similar, or it's very similar. So when we are talking about this triploblast, we are talking about the animals from the phylum Platyhelminthes to Chordata. We are talking from the Platyhelminthes to the Chordata. So, early development in the triploblast. What are these triploblasts? Triploblasts or the triploblastic animals are those animals which are having the three germinal layers in it. Which are having the three germinal layers in it. What are these three germinal layers? Ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Triploblastic animals are those animals which are having the three germinal layers in it. The three germinal layers are ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. And the three, all the organs or the set of the organ has been derived from only these three germinal layers. So here we are talking the same thing, the early development in the triploblast, that we can say that all the organisms have been evolved, or the zygote or the life has been evolved from the single cell, that is zygote. The life is developed, or life has been evolved from the single cell, that is the zygote. This zygote undergoes cleavage and gives a 8 to 16 celled stage called as morula. When there happens a cleavage in the zygote, it gives rise to the next stage, which is called as morula, and it consisted of 8 to 16 cells. Then this morula gives rise to the blastula, and this blastula is a 16 to 32 celled stage. This blastula contains a cavity. This blastula contains a cavity in it, and it is called as blastocoele. This is the cavity. There is one cavity present in the blastula, and that cavity is called as blastocoele. This blastula is the next stage from the morula. This blastula then gives rise to gastrula, and from these gastrula, this gastrula gives rise to the three germinal layers. So, the single cell zygote got cleaved and produces the morula, which is 8 to 16 celled stage. From morula, the blastula. From blastula, the gastrula. And gastrula gives rise to the three germinal layers, which is from which all the organ sets are developed. And the three germinal layers are ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Teen germinal layer se hi kisi bhi organisms ke sare organ sets develop hote hai. And this is common from platyhelminthes to chordata. Yehi procedure zygote se three germinal layer banne ki procedure. This procedure is same from the platyhelminthes up to the chordates. And this is same in highly evolved animals or in the highly evolved mammals also. That is in the human beings also. We used to also follow the same procedure from the zygote up to the formation of the three germinal layers. We also used to follow the same procedure. And the organ sets which are derived from these three germinal layers are also the same. Suppose that the mesoderm. Mesoderm is responsible for the formation of the skeleton system. That is, it forms the bones and the muscles. And the ectoderm, it is responsible for the formation of the nervous system. So, agar humme mesoderm, skeletal system, muscles and bones agar form kar rahi hai, to that mesoderm will only form the bones and the muscles in the less evolved animals also. And that ectoderm will give rise to the nervous system only into the less evolved animals also. So, this was the early development in the triploblast. Ki early development, hamara early development from the platyhelminthes, that which is very lower type of organism, or which it is having the very lower hierarchy in the classification. These are the lower type of organisms. They also follow the same type of early development, and we, the highly evolved human beings, we also follow the same type of early development. This shows that ye hame ye batata hai ki sare organisms ka embryonic life aur sare organisms ka early development is quite similar. This shows that the highly evolved organisms are the have been evolved from the lower type of animals, or these lower animals are the ancestors of the highly evolved animals. The second example which we will take is early development in vertebrates. Here we have discussed about the early development in the triploblast. Here we will discuss about the early development in the vertebrates. So when we are talking about the vertebrates, we are talking from fishes to the highly evolved mammals. We are talking from the fishes up to the mammals. In their early development, they are having the same type of structures like the tail. Tail is present in the embryo of fish also, in the embryo of frog, in reptiles, in birds, and in the mammals also. Tail is present in all the classes of the vertebrate animals. The next, gill slits. Gill slits are also present in all the animals. So these some examples or these some characters shows us that the highly evolved mammal has been evolved from these lower class of the fishes, or the fishes are the ancestors of the animals, and they both are having the same kind of embryonic life. Tails in may be present tha, tails in may be present tha. Gill slits in may be present the, or gill slits in may be present the. But some of the characters have been retained in some animals, and some of the characters were more developed, becomes more developed. For example, in fishes, fishes have retained the characteristic of the tail. In frogs or in the amphibians, when we talk about exception is the frog, because in the tadpole type, the fish in the tadpole the tail is present, but frog is having the retrogressive type of metamorphosis. So retrogressive morphosis mein kya hoga, the tail it is removed, tail remove ho jati hai, and the frog is frog becomes tailless. But in other amphibians, tail is present, like in the salamander, tail is present. And the reptiles also consist of tail, birds also consist of tail. And when we talk about the mammals, agar hum mammals ki baat kare hain, to mammals mein in the monkeys, tail is present. But in the human beings, tail is absent, and they, the tail bone, it is reduced to the coccyx vertebrae in our body. So this shows that the tail and the gill slits, or this shows the early embryonic development of the vertebrates is 90 to 95% similar. And depending upon the type of character, character kaisa hai, some of the characters have been retained and some of the characters got further developed. we have seen or we have observed that comparative diagram of the early embryonic life in the vertebrates. This shows us, this is given in many of our textbooks. Watch that diagram or see that diagram in your textbooks. That diagram particularly shows the each of the embryo of the fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals. And if we see that diagram without the specific names, then we can't say that which of the embryo will give rise to which organism. कौन सा embryo, कौन से organism को develop करने वाला है, या कौन सा organism कौन से organism में बदल, कौन सा embryo कौन से adult organism में बदलने वाला है, हम वो नहीं कह सकते. अगर हमें पता नहीं है कि ये embryo कौन से animal का है, then we can't say that that embryo will give rise to which kind of animal or which animal. So this shows that the early development in the vertebrates is very similar, or it's 90 to 95% similar in the from the fishes to the mammals. The third example which we are going to discuss in the same embryological evidences is temporary development. Temporary development. Sometimes we have seen that कभी कभी ऐसा भी होता है कि कुछ organs temporarily ही embryonic life में present है. For example, tooth birds or tooth eggs. Tooth eggs in birds. The presence of teeth in bird is these teeth are present in bird only in the embryonic life. वो सिर्फ embryonic life में ही bird में present रहेंगे और they are present only in the egg. When that egg is hatched, जब वो egg hatch हो जाता है या hatch होने वाला रहता है, then at that time these teeth from the beak of the bird they get vanished और वो खत्म हो जाते हैं. So this shows that the presence of the teeth is not an avian character. Presence of teeth is an reptilian character. तो reptilian character अगर उनके embryonic life में present है, this shows that this gives us the clue that the birds or the aves are being developed from their ancestors from the reptiles. This shows that the birds are developed from their reptilian type of animals, and due to this reason the birds are also called as glorified reptiles. In their embryonic life tooth were present, पर egg hatch होने के बाद में वो tooth remove हो जाते हैं. तो tooth और presence of the teeth is an reptilian feature. तो जब reptilian feature हमें दिख रहा है, then we can say that the birds have been evolved from the reptiles type of ancestors. The fourth example we will take is about the organs. First organ we will take is heart. We know that in fishes, two-chambered heart is present. In amphibians, three-chambered heart is present. In reptiles, some are three and a half chambered and some are four chambered. Birds and mammals, four chambered heart is present. So birds and mammals, or the mammals, we can say that mammals are called as highly evolved animals. Sabse jyada developed, sabse jyada evolved animals hai mammals or human beings. So mammals mein agar four chambered heart present hai, to kya ye four chambered heart directly four chambered ban gaya? Directly it has been developed into the four chambered from the embryonic life, we can call it as embryonic life se hi kya four chambered heart hi tha jab mammals aur jab development ho raha tha tab embryonic life se hi four chambered heart bana? No, this four chambered heart was developed as first two chambered, three chambered, three and a half chambered, and after that it becomes four chambered. Bhale hi wo ek embryonic, it is the embryonic development of the man or it is the embryonic development of the human being. Though they will be developed as, the first it will be developed as two chambered, next it will become three chambered, then it will become three and a half chambered, and afterwards it will become a four chambered heart. Directly it will not develop as the four chambered heart. So this is also the strong evidence or the strong clue which shows that the human beings are being evolved from the lower class of the vertebrata. The next example in these organs are about the brain and the kidney. These both are also developed like this only. They have been not developed instantaneously or suddenly. Ye bhi suddenly jada ekdam se nahi evolve hue hai. these are also developed as in these procedure only. The fifth example which we are going to take in the embryological evidences is recapitulation theory. Recapitulation theory. This theory was first given by Von Baer. This theory was given by Von Baer. What Von Baer said that general structures are evolved first, then the specialized structure. General structures are evolved first, then the specialized structure. जो general structures हैं, common type के structures हैं, जो generally सभी organisms में present रहते हैं, वो पहले evolve होते हैं as compared to that of the specialized structure. When we call talking about the general type of structure, like the axial skeleton, this is a general type of a structure which is present in all the organisms. So these general or the presence of eyes and ears, these are some general type of structures. And when we are talking about the specialized type of structures, wings in birds, hairs in mammals, free caudal in reptiles. So these are some general structures and these are some specialized structure. So Von Baer ke according, general or the common structures were evolved first and the specialized structure were evolved afterwards. This was the theory, recapitulation theory, which was given by the Von Baer. And in the light of evolution, in the light of evolution, this theory was again modified as the biogenetic law. This theory, the recapitulation theory in the light of evolution, was again modified as the biogenetic law. And this law was given by Ernst Haeckel. The biogenetic law, which was the modified form, we can say, of the recapitulation theory, this was given by the Ernst Haeckel. What he stated, he said only one statement: ontogeny repeats phylogeny. He said ontogeny repeats phylogeny. What is meant by ontogeny?